The world statistics of recent years clearly indicates biathlon is currently gaining popularity all over the world. By now, rankings of the main competitions of this sport are comparable to hockey and even football. Kazakhstan is not an exception. And if you try to figure out the reasons of the popularity of biathlon, each citizen of the Republic of Kazakhstan who knows even a little about this sport will mention Elena Khrustaleva. The athlete, who has gained some experience in biathlon, performing in competitions as part of the national team of Russia and Belarus. But she won her major victories performing under the flag of Kazakhstan. She is a girl whose name is a synonym of success for Kazakhstani sports people in the main Olympic Winter Games last decades. She is a person who was in several teams. She was a member of Russia and Belarus national teams. She is an ambitious person and a workaholic. She had a desire to achieve more of what she had already accomplished at that time, and she reached her goal in our team. Elena made her first steps to the Olympic podium in Krasnoyarsk, Russia. Her parents were passionate about hiking, and they would take their children with them. That's when the future champion got up on skis for the first time.
Мы всегда ходили по лесу, прогулки выходного дня.
We used to always go hiking in the woods at weekends. We lived in the city suburbs, and the forest was really close. The forest was right behind our window. We used to go skiing or hiking there. When I was six, we came to Almaty to hike in the mountains. We've been here two times. During the trek, the Khrustalevs reached the lake called the Big Almaty Mountain Lake. Elena fell in love with the canyon that has the same name. She still hikes up to see the lake, the beauty of nature and the terrain. Since then, it has become one of my favorite places around Almaty. But I didn't love other trekking, hiking or backpacking so much. I did not like it at all, even though we would go hiking in big companies for us kids and our family friends with their kids. We used to play, run around and have fun, but I hated it so much. Then a moment came when Elena had to choose, either go hiking with a heavy backpack or skiing light. That's when she chose cross-country skiing and rifle shooting, the sport that came from the north, where people used to hunt while skiing. I had to decide, either I go to the sport base and train, or go trekking with my parents. Since I didn't like trekking and hiking, I decided to go training. And since then, every year, I have been training as a biathlete. In sports, just like in life, moments of change happen. Elena had such a moment when she decided to change a country. Since 2006, she has been successfully representing Kazakhstan, where she used to come for training many times before. I fell in love with Almaty and Kazakhstan. So did my dad and my entire family. At some point, when I was in Russia, I realized I wasn't going to be in the all-Russia team. While training there, I couldn't go to the World Championships and my results were going slightly down. So I had to think what to do next. I contacted the Kazakh Biathlon Federation and then decided to move here. It so happened that over 12 years and three Winter Olympics, Salt Lake City in 2002, Torino in 2006, Kazakhstani sports people won a silver medal in winter sports only in Vancouver in 2010. And the winner of this medal was Elena Khrustaleva. She performed brilliantly in the 15-kilometer individual race, conceding only 20 seconds to the Norwegian sportsman Tor Berger. She was a three-time European champion before that, two-time silver and one-time bronze medalist in the World Championships. She also performed well at the Olympics in 2002. But her breakthrough started at the largest sport event in Vancouver. Honored Master of Sports of Russia and Kazakhstan, and recently also the Vice President of the Biathlon Union of Kazakhstan, Elena Khrustaleva remembers her debut in the first team. It wasn't spectacular. I got my first medal at the Asian Games. My coaches expected me to perform a little better. But I was third and second in relay, then I had better races in World Cups. I entered the top 30, but my results weren't stable. As soon as snow covers mountain slopes, biathletes arrive to Yelena's favorite Big Almaty Canyon, where they start their day with training. Aside from the road, skiing, several kilometers in one end, several kilometers in the other. You have to be prepared for the season, and biathletes drive to the base in Soldiers Canyon, where they will hone their technique on a firing range.
К Олимпиаде мы готовились здесь, в горах, в Алмате и на Иссык-Куле в основном.
We were getting ready for the Olympics mainly here, in Almaty, and at Lake Issyk-Kul. We were skiing, changing altitudes from 1,500 meters to 2,500 meters. When you go up, your blood composition changes, your hemoglobin goes up. And when you go down from the mountains, your performance is getting better. That's why we train in the mountains. This training mode is long, used by scientists and sports physicians. It was many times applied to train athletes before the most important contests. The healthy climate of the mountains is accompanied by such factors as elevated solar radiation, high air ionization, thin air, lowered oxygen, partial pressure. Mountain training helps to increase the aerobic capacity and the functional status of athletes. That fact helps to improve their results. I came sixth at the World Championship in Korea. It was quite a surprise for me and for others. That's when my confidence started to grow, and an Olympic year was good for me as well. We trained very hard, with no setbacks. We trained here in Kazakhstan most of the time, in Almaty, Issyk-Kul, Chuchinsk. We skied here in the mountains little by little, from start to start, and by January I got into the top 30 again. I performed well at the Olympics as well. I plucked up my courage and did well. On the eve of the 2010 Vancouver Olympics, Khrustaleva had a serious goal, which was to enter the top six. She came fifth in 7.5 km sprint, 11th in 10 km pursuit with four shootings. The main surprise Yelena presented in the individual race at 15 kilometers was 41 minutes and 13 seconds and a half. She took second place and a silver Olympic medal, the medal that the whole country was waiting for. I experienced two distinct emotions at the same time. First, I finally got an Olympic medal. It was my goal for 15 years before that. And then I felt pride for my host country, Kazakhstan. For Kazakh people who believed in me, I started feeling even greater love to Kazakhstan. I liked it here, but then I got a strong inner feeling that I really belonged here. I was so happy and proud to see how Kazakhstan and Kazakh fans were happy that I got this medal. And I was happy that I could do it for them. Personally, I was lucky enough to attend the Olympic Games in 2010 in Vancouver. I watched the victory of Yelena Khrustaleva. We were all incredibly proud of Kazakhstani athletes, proud of people who glorify our country. It was very cool. We had indescribable feeling at that moment. Really incredible. Dias Kenyshev has been training with Yelena for many years, taking part in international tournaments with her. He is one of the Kazakh biathlon national team leaders, representative of the Olympic team at the Winter Games in Vancouver. He continues to learn from Yelena.
Ты единственный человек, которому стремиться можно постоянно. И до сих пор стремиться.
She is the only person I want to set as an example to you. I like the way she trains, what she does. It's great motivation for any young sports people. Even for a professional, I learn something new from her every year. It helps me in all competitions.
С неё берёшь. На всех соревнованиях это очень сильная поддержка.
When Yelena has some free time, she's still training. Weightlifting is good for every athlete. And though cross-country skiing is considered one of the best sports for harmonious development of a person's body, it is still not enough for Yelena. Besides, Yelena loves ballet and goes to choreography classes. It looks like any physical activity is giving her joy and a lot of positive emotions. For social and fun-loving Yelena, it is also a way of making new friends. Not every sportsperson is able to win a silver Olympic medal, but receiving it did not stop Khrustaleva from improving her skills. She has a lot of goals and she is getting ready for new winnings, training and aiming at a target. She worked hard. We coaches worked hard too. Biathletes compete after 40 if they feel that they still have potential and motivation to achieve something.
Ресурсы, у него есть какая-то мотивация достичь чего-то еще.
The age of an athlete is short, but the heart is strong, the lungs pump frosty winter air in and out, and you want to slide in the snow on your skis even more. Khrustaleva is a role model for young athletes. And every day they ski many kilometers. Snow falls from fir tree branches and crunches under skis. On the run, and skier feels hot. We hired a new coach from Russia, Valery Nikolaevich Alkhovsky, and the new president of our federation restructures the new team. Elena Khrustaleva competed in the Sochi Olympics. Her Kazakh friends were rooting for her, but fortune was not in her favor this time.
Kazakhstan стал для меня домом. Это раз.
Kazakhstan feels like home to me. It is also the place for me where I can have a rest and just relax. I like being here. I met a lot of new, interesting and diverse friends. That sometimes I wonder how come that this small piece of land has so many interesting people. I think Elena Khrustaleva is a worthy representative of Kazakhstani athletes in the international sports arena. Life paths that we choose. If as a kid Yelena would have chosen going trekking with a backpack behind her shoulders, there wouldn't have been famous Olympic silver medalist biathlete Yelena Khrustaleva.